many, many people that I see that come to me, in the first place, they are very stressed and they are almost depressed, and they're very nervous, and they emotionally very imbalanced. And with the period of fasting, you can really see how they get relaxed and how they open up, how they start smiling, and how they feel better.
The biggest effect that even I, who work in a fasting clinic, grew up in a family that promotes fasting since 100 years, every time I fast, I'm surprised at the way I, I clear up my mind, and the way that the fasting metabolism has this profound effect of mental clarity. Otto Buchinger already said, don't worry about the body. The body in fasting is something that is working by itself, but focus on the mind. And focus on feeding the mind something where you basically feed the fasting soul or the fasting mind good food. And I perceive this every time as a miracle. I take a book into fasting, or I listen to a piece of music, or I go out in nature, and every time I see it in a different way, in a more clear, in a more subtle way. And I change into another person. I become more sensitive, I become more attentive, I sleep differently, I have different thoughts, and I always come out of a fasting much richer in ideas and personal experiences. And this is every time a miracle for me.
Well, the most impressive effect on fasting is not really from our own studies, but the ones from Walter Longo in cancer patients. I thought this is really fascinating, that patients who get chemotherapy and do fasting before have better outcomes, they have less side effects. I think this is really interesting. What we are now doing in clinical practice is fasting diet before surgery. So patients who get surgery for in cancer as well, either metastases, liver metastases, or patients before weight loss surgery, they are put on a fasting or very low caloric restriction diet before, because they have less complications after surgery. So I think these two things are really fascinating.
I would say the thing that always impresses me about fasting is how broad the effects are. Almost in any organ system that you look in, you can see profound changes. So everything from the immune system, the skeletal muscular system, the cardiovascular system, there's profound changes in all of these. I think the really interesting thing about fasting and the interesting thing about studying it is that we can find something extremely interesting anywhere we look in the body, and it makes it a really rich area for studying.
Me personally, there's the fact that people, I would say, many, many people that I see that come to me, in the first place, they are very stressed and they are almost depressed, and they're very nervous, and they emotionally very imbalanced. And with the period of fasting, you can really see how they get relaxed and how they open up, how they start smiling, and how they feel better. So the general well-being, not only physically but also emotionally, this is what really is nice to see, because the working is a different work together between a therapist and the person who is doing the fasting. And to follow that path, that's so interesting, because the conversations, they change, and the topics change, and the perspective in the person change. So that's it's always really fascinating, because it shows how they get a different perspective on their own life, which I find always very fascinating. Apart from all the other factors, of course, laboratory results and the clinical results, but this is what really I find, because it makes my work very interesting.
I would say probably one of the most interesting things about the fasting experience that has surprised me has been the emotional well-being of the patients or the participants who, you know, undergo these interventions. Classically, when you think about it, you know, taking away food for 10, 15, 20 days is not something you would associate with improved emotional well-being. And I think a hallmark of, you know, the Bukinga fast is that the patients are, you know, at the end of the fast reporting how much better they feel, their emotional well-being is, you know, significantly improved. And, you know, this is really contrary to what you would think about removing food. And this is, you know, one of the things I find super interesting about the whole fasting experience.
It changes a lot of gene activity inside the body, and that has to do with anti-inflammatory activity, antioxidant, repair mechanisms, and anti-aging. Because of this metabolic shift that happens into the body when you fast, you consume, when you don't fast, glucose mostly, and when you fast, you consume lipids. This metabolic shift drives all the cellular machinery to a new environment, and this was found in the scientific reports that has to do with anti-inflammatory actions, anti-aging actions, autophagy, repair, and antioxidant activity. All of this, if you combine, we call it metabolic health.
Yes, I think about fasting, the most surprising findings we have found lately is that the longer you fast, the better you feel, because once your body has adapted to the new metabolism and has totally fulfilled the switch, it gets better and better in terms of well-being, and also even the brain functions better. So this is also something we see in the praxis in our clinics, that if patients fast for 2 or even 3 weeks, they feel better and better. And most of the time, they even say the third week is the best one. So this is something that we nowadays also can see in the scientific world, because our parameters go back to normal, they all get back to the baseline, but also in the brain and the well-being are a lot of improvements happening the longer they fast. So this is really surprising.
I would say that the fasting is not in, for our topic, is therapeutic. Because therapeutic is something that requires a dose and a constant adherence to a therapy. I would say that is a regimen, a lifestyle that impressed us because we didn't know. At least when I say we didn't know, it's the group I work with. And what impressed us the most was the real impact in the changes that we found in terms of lipoproteins. Which lipoproteins? The lipoproteins which are called atherogenic lipoproteins and are the lipoproteins that drive the most the atherosclerosis, so they are the most that are related with the development of atherosclerosis. And what I, as I said this morning, during the presentation, the field of lipids is very complicated. It is not so easy as vulgarly we define the best and the good cholesterol. But in few words, what impressed me the most was this huge drop in atherogenic lipoproteins after 14 days, an effect that was not unexpected, but was more impressive compared to the 7 days fasting.
All the effects are very, very surprising or very exciting. That's such in such a short period, like a week or so of fasting, that you have sometimes so so big effects already. For example, in the laboratory findings, you see with diabetic patients, their HbA1c, which is the long-term sugar and which usually changes after 3 months. This is what the doctors tell the patients, that it shows the last 3 months how your sugar was managed through your medication when you are a diabetic patient. And after this week, we already most of the times see a drop in HbA1c, and this is exciting. And then when you do imaging from the liver, or we just heard the talk about the MRI, and I think it's impressive how fast the body changes during fasting on the physical side, and on the mental side, of course, it's an amazing experience. The realization that you have control of your body, that you can't, that you can go over a week without eating actually, and then also if you do it on a secluded site like Buchinger Clinic, for example, with all the nice therapies around it and the chance to really relax and to meditate and to be centered in yourself. I think this is also in the psychological and the mental area. It most of the time gives strong changes and very positive changes.